नमस्ते बच्चों, हमेशा खुश रहो। मायसेल्फ जीवी डॉक्टर मोनिका त्रिवेदी। आई एम फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी, फैकल्टी ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड मेट्रोलॉजी, ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द क्रिस्टल फील्ड थ्योरी एंड डी डी स्प्लिटिंग इन ऑक्टाहेड्रल क्रिस्टल्स, टेट्राहेड्रल क्रिस्टल्स, स्क्वायर पिरामिड क्रिस्टल्स एंड we will also discuss about the crystal field stabilization parameter and crystal field stabilization energy. So, as we all know that the bonding in a transition metal complexes can explain by two approaches. First is a molecular orbital theory, second is a crystal field theory. Okay, in molecular orbital theory, as we know that it is a covalent approach in which the overlapping between the d orbital and the ligand molecule is a form. Okay, but in a crystal field theory, it is a ionic approach and it is considered as a ligand as a point charge around the central metal, which is a positive ion. Okay, in this kind of theory, the negative charge on a ligand is repelled by the electron in a d orbital of a metal. The orientation of a d orbital with respect to the ligand around the central metal ion is important, and the 5d orbital are degenerated if they present in a same energy level. Whereas the d orbital point along or in the between the certain axis determine how the orbital are split into a group when present in a different energies. Okay, for example, the splitting of a d orbital for octahedral, the square pair and tetrahedral ligand geometries. In this diagram you can see the d orbitals of dx square, dx square, y square, dz square, dx square, y square, dyz, dx, dxz, dyxy. Okay, this five orbital are the orbitals of octahedral, tetrahedral, square planar geometry. Okay. So in octahedral field, if we see that the complex present in an octahedral arrangement, in this kind of arrangement the complex field two kind of forces. First is the electrostatic attraction and second is the electrostatic repulsion. The attraction in between the electrons and between the ligands in a positive metal ion, and the second repulsion is occur between the ligand and the electrons in a d orbitals. Okay, if we talk about which kind of groups of d orbital is directly towards on the face of the ligand. So if you talk about dxy, dxz, dyz, dx square and dx square, y square, these are five orbitals of a d orbital. Okay, if there is a repulsion between the electron and a d orbital, then the lone pair on a ligand, this will be degenerated. Okay, and in this stage, the all 5d orbital will the energy is rise and it become the same amount. However, the electron in the orbital pointed towards the ligand are repelled by the ligand lone pair to generate the extent than the pointing in the between the ligand, because they are close to the metal. Okay, hence the dx square, dy square, z, dx square, y square orbitals are destabilized to the greater extent than the dxy, dyz, dxz orbitals. Okay, and the degeneration remove. Okay, if we talk about the d orbital splitting diagram of an octahedral field, the d orbital for an octahedral complexes can be split in this form. Okay, there is a ground state of a metal where the dx square, y square, dxz square, dxy, dxz and dyz have a same energy level. Okay, when the ligand attach to the metal ion, the d orbital of complex will split. Okay, it will split in a dx square y square dz square with a high energy and the low energy with the dxy, dxz and dyz orbital. Here you can see in this diagram the splitting energy here denoted by the del O, and the d orbital will split into T2g and eg group of a orbitals. Okay, so there is a two sets of labeled as EG and T2G are they are separated between the ligand field stabilizing splitting parameter, which is a del O, where is a subscript O is used as a octahedral crystal field. Okay, and this is the if you talk about the tetrahedral field, okay, and in a tetrahedral complexes the complex present in a tetrahedral arrangement of ligand around the central metal ion. The best way to picture this arrangement is now that the ligand is present in a opposite corner of a cube. In this diagram you can see the ligands are present in a opposite corners of a cube. As with the octahedral complexes, there is an electrostatic attraction between each of ligand and the positive metal ion, and there is an electrostatic repulsion between ligand and the electrons of a d orbital. Okay, so this is the in this tetrahedral field, the splitting in a tetrahedral field is opposite to the octahedral field. Now in this diagram you can see that the with the low energy dx square and dx y square and dz square present in a with the E symbol and a low energy, and dx square dy square dxz d yz and dxy are present in a higher energy level. Okay, so there is a two sets are present which is labeled by E and T2. The subscript G is not needed here, so it is only used for the system of center of symmetry. In tetrahedral system we do not need the center of symmetry. Okay, so the separation between the two set of orbitals it's presented by del T. The T is here is a tetrahedral crystal field. It should be noted that the energy of del T is smaller than the del octahedral. Okay, so if we consider the energy of tetrahedral it is a 1/4 1/9 del octahedral. Okay, now we consider the square planar field. If you consider the square planar field, the octahedral complex is the six ligands centered on a certain axis, then removed to trans ligand. Okay, the two ligands centered on the z axis. Now this arrangement is a square planar arrangement. Okay, and by removing the two ligand has an effect to the stabilizing the orbital, which pointed directly or partially along with the z axis, that is the dz square dyz and dxz orbital are stabilized. Okay, so in a electrons in this orbital suffer less repulsion and suffer less repulsion than in the octahedral field. So they have a lowered energy. As the dz square orbital pointed directly along to the z axis, it is stabilized to greater extent than the xy, dyz and dxz orbital, which is pointed in the between the z axis. Okay, this is the splitting diagram of square planar complexes. Here you can see the first the d orbital is split into dxz, dyz and dxy, and dx square, dy square, dz square. Okay, like a octahedral field. Now after if we remove the two axis bond which is present on a z axis, so the orbitals present on a z axis are destabilized. Okay, and they go to the low energy like dyz, dxz and d y dx y. Okay, and the dx square and dy square and dz square have a higher energy. Now this will further split into this, and the lowest energy having orbitals are dx z, dy z, and after that dz square is a have a lower energy. Then after the high energy is of dx square, y square, and dx y. Okay, so this is the crystal field splitting in dd splitting in a octahedral complexes of dd splitting in a octahedral, tetrahedral, and a square planar complexes. Okay, now the which parameters are present in a splitting in a crystal field splitting? Okay, in octahedral or a tetrahedral crystal, the d orbital are split into two state. The energy separation between them is called as a crystal field splitting parameter. Okay, and it is given by the symbol del O for octahedral and del T for a tetrahedral field. In both cases, the overall stabilization of one set of orbital equals to the overall destabilization of other set. In the octahedral field, overall stabilization of T2G set equals to the overall destabilization of EG set. Okay, if you talk about EG set, is rises by the 2 unit. The T2G set is lowered by 3 unit to achieve this energy balance. Therefore, the EG set is raised by 0.6 del 0, and the T2G set is lowered by 0.4 del 0. Okay, that is the same. The sum of this these energies is equals to 10 dq instant of del 0. Okay, so this is the comparative diagrams of octahedral and tetrahedral field. Here you can see the energy level of T2G and EG here, which is minus 0.4 del 0 and plus 0.6 del octahedral. This is EG and this is T2G. In tetrahedral field, the energy level is changes, and for E, the crystal field parameter energy del minus 0.6 del T and plus 0.4 del T for T2. Okay, and if the all things are equal, then the del T is smaller than del 0, which is the del T is equals to 4 by 9 del 0, and which is also equals to 1 by 2 del 0 or del octahedral. Okay, so if we compare the splitting in a tetrahedral and octahedral field, this is the diagram of tetrahedral and octahedral field, and the energy of crystal field splitting is greater in the octahedral field as compared to the tetrahedral field. Okay, so this is all about the crystal field splitting in the orbital. Thank you very much.